Welcome to the video tutorial for ASCENT, which stands for Automated Simulations to Characterize Electrical Nerve Thresholds. The software was developed in Dr. Warren Grill's lab in the Department of Biomedical Engineering at Duke University in Durham, North Carolina, with financial support from the NIH Spark program. I am Daniel Marshall, a doctoral student in the Grill lab and developer, maintainer, and product support for ASCENT. The software was originally developed by Grill Lab doctoral student Eric Musselman and undergraduate student Jake Cariello with the supervision and support of Drs. Nikki Pillow and Warren Grill. If you use ASCENT, please make sure to cite our paper. I've placed a link to the publication as well as a ready-to-use citation in the video description. ASCENT is a software platform for anatomically realistic biophysical computational modeling of electrical stimulation of the peripheral nervous system. It's an enabling technology that allows non-experts to use computational modeling techniques to assess the impact of nerve morphology, cuff design, tissue and material properties, stimulation waveform, and axon biophysics on neural responses to electrical signals for activation or block. With standardized inputs and outputs, ASCENT readily enables model reproducibility. This video is intended to help first-time users in getting started with ASCENT. I will walk you through setup of version 1.2.1 of the ASCENT pipeline, followed by the implementation and simulation of a complete model of nerve stimulation. I'm running ASCENT on a Windows machine, but ASCENT can also be run on macOS and Linux. The installation process across operating systems is quite similar, and I will highlight differences as we go through the process together. Before we get started, I suggest pulling up the ASCENT documentation in a separate window so that you can follow along as I go through the installation steps. A link to the documentation is in the video description, or you can navigate to the URL shown on the screen now. In the bottom left, you can select a version of the documentation to use. I'm going to choose the latest version, 1.2.1, since that's what I'm using for this tutorial. Feel free to follow along with this video using newer versions of ASCENT and the documentation, but keep in mind that some steps may have changed. On the left, navigate to the Getting Started page, and at the top of this page you'll see the installation instructions. The first step is to install all required software dependencies: Python, Java, Console Multiphysics, and Neuron. Aside from Console, all this software is free to install. A Console license of version 5.4 or newer is required to run ASCENT. Note that on Mac and Linux you must also install some additional packages, which are listed in the documentation. Go ahead and pause this video and follow the instructions. When you have everything installed, come back here. Once you have all the prerequisite software installed, our first step is to clone the ASCENT repository to your computer. Following along with the documentation, this is step number one under installing ASCENT. To do that, click the link to ASCENT's GitHub page, located in the text of installation step one. We're going to click this green code button in the top right and copy the HTTPS address. Then, navigate to the directory where you want to clone ASCENT and open Git Bash. Type git clone and then right-click and paste the HTTPS address. When you hit enter, Git will generate a local version of the ASCENT code on your computer. We are actively developing ASCENT. After installation, you can always get the newest version of the repository using the git pull command. The current version of ASCENT is controlled exclusively through user-defined configuration files and the command line. We are in the process of developing a graphical user interface which will allow users to easily configure and execute runs of ASCENT. In addition, the graphical user interface will ship with an installer, which should streamline the installation process. Now, we're going to run the installation script to set up our ASCENTCon environment and install the necessary Python packages and libraries. See step 2 in the documentation. I'm using Windows, so I'm going to open Anaconda PowerShell prompt. On Mac or Linux, you can use the regular Anaconda prompt. Navigate to the directory containing your ASCENT installation and enter the command python run install. The installation will ask you if you're in the correct directory. Answer yes to continue. At a point, Anaconda will ask you to confirm package installation. Also enter yes here. The installation script will create a new ASCENT conda environment in which the packages will be installed, which will guarantee that the installed software does not affect any of your other Python projects. Next, we need to set up our environment variables. To run any ASCENT code, we need to be in the ASCENT conda environment. Activate this environment created by the installation script with the command conda activate ASCENT. Enter the command python run env underscore setup. I'm going to add four paths, the path to my console installation, the bin path of my Java installation, the root path of my ASCENT directory, and the path where I want neuron simulation files to be exported. For this last one, I'm going to choose a subdirectory out in my ASCENT directory. ASCENT will create this directory during our first run. For example paths on Windows and Mac, see env.json under JSON file parameter guides in the Read the Docs ASCENT documentation. Now that the ASCENT software is fully installed, we're ready to go through an example run of the pipeline together. ASCENT has four stages. The sample stage defines how your input nerve morphology is processed. The model stage builds and solves the finite element model, and the sim stage prepares the biophysical simulations of individual nerve fibers. Finally, in the submit stage, the simulations prepared in the sim stage are computed, and then we can analyze our results. We'll run the pipeline in three steps. First, a run command which executes the first three stages. Second, a submit command to execute stage four. And finally, plotting the resulting data using one of many provided analysis scripts to generate a heat map of activation thresholds. First, we need to define the nerve morphology. ASCENT currently models 3D nerves by using a 2D cross-section of the nerve and fascicles. This 2D cross-section is extruded in the longitudinal direction to generate a three-dimensional nerve. The 2D cross-section is defined using input masks. These masks are binary images of segmented histology. See the documentation page Morphology Input Files for resources on image segmentation. For this tutorial, we will use a provided mask image. After setting up our input morphology, we'll create the required configuration files for a run of the pipeline. These JSON configuration files can be opened in any text editor, such as Notepad. In this video, I use Atom. For this part, you can follow along with the documentation on the same Getting Started page under Tutorial Run. We're using the files in the examples/tutorial directory to define the nerve morphology. Note that I'll refer to this as the tutorial directory from here on. Our three images here are the raw histology image, included for reference, but not used for building the model, the segmented mask of the monofascicular nerve, where the perineurium is denoted with white pixels, and the scale bar, which will tell the pipeline how to convert from pixels to microns. If you were modeling a multifascicular nerve, there would be an additional segmented mask for the nerve boundary. Take these three images and create a subdirectory in your ASCENT input directory. In this example, I name the folder Tutorial. Place a copy of the images here. Note that the input file name prefixes need to match the name of the directory they are in, but ASCENT will take care of this automatically since we name the files to the following convention: r.tiff for the raw image, c.tiff for the fascicle mask, and s.tiff for the scale bar. This naming convention can change based off your mask input method, so be sure to check the documentation on morphology input files for the method that you're using. In this tutorial, we're using the compiled method, thus the mask is named c.tiff. Now that we define the nerve morphology input images, we need to set up a directory where the inputs for the nerve sample will be processed and where all related finite element models and neuron simulation files will be located. We will refer to this as a sample directory. The sample configuration contains parameters related to a specific nerve morphology. This configuration will control how the input masks are processed in preparation for 3D representation in the console finite element model. The pipeline will also generate attributes in the file which control how the 3D nerve geometry is built from your input images. Navigate to your ASCENT samples directory and create a new subdirectory with a unique index, 0 or a positive integer, to identify the sample moving forward. I'll use 0. We could choose any index not previously used for another sample. From the tutorial directory, I'm going to copy over the sample configuration file named sample.json, leaving the file name as is. If we open this file, you'll see many parameters which can be defined based on how you would like the input masks of nerve morphology to be processed to define the 3D nerve in the finite element model. For now, we'll leave these parameters alone, but note that the sample field matches the name we chose earlier for our input subdirectory, tutorial. We specified the folder with input morphology images, called tutorial, for this specific sample index, numbered 0 in this example. You can actually create different samples, each with its own index, that define their nerve morphology from the same input directory of images. More information on the sample JSON file and its variables, as well as the other JSON files that we'll set up, can be found in the documentation under JSON configuration files and JSON file parameter guide. Now, we need to set up our model. Each sample can have one or more associated models. Each model will specify different parameters for how the COMSOL multiphysics simulation is set up, but all models will use the same nerve morphology defined by the sample. The model parameters define all aspects of the COMSOL finite element model, including the geometry of the cuff electrode, the cuff position on the nerve, and material properties used in the electric current simulation. In the same directory as the sample.json file that we just copied over, we'll create a directory called models. To create a single model, we'll create a subdirectory with a unique index in the models directory that we just created. I'll use 0. We could choose any index that is 0 or a positive integer that was not previously used for another model configuration in this sample. Inside this directory, we'll copy over our model.json file, leaving the file name as is, from the tutorial directory. If you open this file, you'll see the variables associated with the finite element model, including building and meshing the geometry, assigning physics parameters and equations, and solving the system to obtain the distribution of electrical potentials throughout the tissues in response to the electric current from the cuff electrode. For now, we'll leave the contents of model.json as is, but you can read more about specific parameters in the JSON file parameter guide page of the documentation. Now that our model is set up, we need to set up our sim configuration. A sim configuration file defines the parameters for simulating nerve fibers in a software called Neuron. These simulations use biophysical, multi-compartment models of nerve fibers, also called axons. For example, the sim.json file defines how fibers are populated within the nerve, as well as what parameters we'll use to stimulate the fibers. Extracellular potentials are sampled from the solved COMSOL finite element model in the sim stage. The sampled extracellular potentials are applied to a biophysical cable model of an axon using the specified fiber model, fiber diameter, and stimulation waveform. Copy the sim.json file from the tutorial directory into config/user/sims. We'll need to give the sim file a unique index. I'll rename it to 0.json. We could choose any index that is 0 or a positive integer that was not previously used for another sim configuration. For now, we'll leave this sim.json file as is. But as with the other JSON files, if you want to change these parameter values, the documentation will be your best friend. Our last step before we're ready to run the pipeline is to set up a run configuration file. The run configuration file provides the basic information that we need to execute a run of the pipeline. In the run configuration, we indicate which sample index we're using, meaning which images define the nerve morphology. We also specify which models we want to run, meaning which parameters define the COMSOL finite element models of the 3D nerve and cuff electrode. Finally, as we go through these models, this configuration file will also control which sims we're using for each, meaning which parameters define the neuron simulations to model biophysical nerve fibers. In config/user/runs, we'll copy run.json from the config/templates directory and rename it with a unique index. I'm again going to use 0, but we could use any index that is 0 or a positive integer that was not previously used for another run configuration. Place the appropriate indices in run.json, which you chose in the last steps to define the sample, model, and sim instances. In my case, I use 0 for everything. There are some other variables in run.json that can change how a run functions, but for now, we'll leave them as is. For more information on these, see the ASCENT documentation. Now that we've set up all our JSON configuration files, we're ready to run the pipeline. Open your Anaconda prompt and navigate to your ASCENT directory. After activating the environment with the command conda activate ASCENT, enter the command python run pipeline 0. The 0 refers to the index of the run JSON configuration file that we just created, which governs which sample, models, and sims we're executing. ASCENT will construct and solve the COMSOL finite element model of the 3D nerve and cuff according to your sample and model JSON parameters. It will then sample the resulting distributions of electric potentials along the fiber positions defined in your sim.json file. It will also prepare the neuron simulation folders according to your sim.json parameters. The potentials sampled from the COMSOL model will be used as inputs to neuron simulations that calculate a fiber's response to your defined stimulation waveform. ASCENT can execute three types of neuron simulations, depending on the setup defined in sim.json. 1. Determination of activation thresholds. 2. Determination of block thresholds. Or 3. Fiber response to fixed amplitudes. If running a threshold simulation, Neuron will use a bisection search to identify the minimum current amplitude at which the fiber is activated or blocked. If running a fixed amplitude simulation, Neuron will simulate the response of the fiber to a fixed amplitude of the stimulation waveform. In this tutorial, we're using a bisection search algorithm to find thresholds for fiber activation. Now that the pipeline has completed executing the COMSOL finite element model, let's look at the resulting outputs before we proceed to the neuron portion of the pipeline. If you look in the sample/0/models/0 subdirectory, you can see that we now have a lot more files. The sims directory contains all the information for each sim that will be executed in Neuron. Each sim index is assigned its own unique directory. Within each index sim subdirectory, a directory called n_sims contains the files necessary to run each set of Neuron fiber simulations. You can see that we have just one subdirectory inside nsims due to the parameter values in our sim.json file. But you might have more if you define multiple values for a given parameter, such as waveform pulse width, fiber diameter, or contact weighting. Along with sim.json, the files in these directories define the inputs to our neuron simulations. We can now run the neuron simulations to find the activation threshold for each fiber. ASCENT copy the nsim folders to our output directory. So navigate to the output directory that you chose during environment setup. In my case, it's called out. ASCENT has set up the files required for neuron fiber simulations. Note that your output folder is designed to be able to run independent of the rest of ASCENT. This means you could copy this folder to another computer or to a high-performance computing cluster to execute your fiber simulations. We can run our simulations with the command python submit.py0. Again, the 0 refers to the run configuration, config/user/runs/0.json that we created earlier. This submit.py command will compile the necessary neuron files and then start our fiber simulations. The compilation step will automatically be skipped in future calls of submit.py. Enter 1 to confirm that you want to start the simulations. The computation may take a while, so let's come back when they're finished. Now that our neuron simulations have finished running, we're ready to analyze our data. Let's navigate back to the main ASCENT directory. First, we're going to get the data from the neuron simulations with the command python run import_n_sims0. Again, the 0 refers to the run configuration that we created earlier. This command will move the data from our neuron simulation directory back to our ASCENT sample directory structure. If we now look in our sample model sim subdirectory, we can see that our nsims directory has the activation thresholds that were output from our neuron simulations. Now that we have the threshold values, we can run analysis scripts to plot the data. For this tutorial, we'll create a heat map of activation thresholds. Open the script examples/analysis/threshold-heatmap.py. Edit the sample, model, and sim indices to match the values that you chose earlier. We'll also leave the output directory as the default, in the root directory of ASCENT. Then, close this script and use Anaconda prompt to navigate to the root ASCENT directory. Run the script using the command python examples/analysis/threshold-heatmap.py. In the root directory, you should now have a figure showing a heat map of activation thresholds. This was just one example. Using ASCENT, you can run several other types of simulations with an incredible degree of control over the parameters defining them. We also provide many more analysis scripts in examples/analysis. Feel free to use them to analyze your data. For more information on how to use ASCENT, check out our paper in PLOS Computational Biology and our Read the Docs documentation. For discussion and to report issues using ASCENT, check out our GitHub page. Links for all of these are in the description. If you use ASCENT in your research, please make sure to cite our paper and the ASCENT code. Remember to use the correct DOI for the version of the code that you use. ASCENT was developed by members of the GRIL Lab at Duke University with funding from the NIH Spark program. Thanks for watching.